Hello, and welcome to another episode of Retro Cartridge Hunt. Today's episode is going to be slightly different, as we're not going to be looking at cartridges that I've recently tracked down, but instead, the peripherals that go with them. What do I mean? Today, we're talking about light guns.
Welcome to my party, we're just getting started. A life is a dream or a nightmare scarring. Hand me a drink, cause I think I'm going all in. Get me a shrink who can catch me when I'm falling. Cover up my scars, flip the handlebars. Crashing in my car, wake up in a bar. I'll be a superstar, just on my avatar. This world is so bizarre, empty out the reservoir.
Yes, today is all about my favorite video game accessory, the light gun. And I do have a modest collection already. We're going to start where most of us probably started, and that's with the original Nintendo Entertainment System and the Zapper. While the Zapper came bundled with the NES, it really didn't get many games dedicated to it. In fact, several of the games it did get could also be played with the main gamepad controller. Beginning with the nationwide rollout of the NES in 1986, Duck Hunt was one of several titles Nintendo included as a pack-in game with some of its releases. The initial deluxe set included Duck Hunt and Gyromite. The later action set was packaged with Duck Hunt and Super Mario Bros. This was the version that I had as a kid. In Duck Hunt, the ducks appear one or two at a time, and the player is given three shots to shoot them down. The player receives points upon shooting each duck. If the player shoots the required number of ducks in a single round, the player will advance to the next round. Otherwise, the player will receive a game over. Duck Hunt has three different game modes to choose from. In Game A and Game B, the targets are flying ducks in a woodland area. And in Game C, the targets are clay pigeons that are launched away from the player's perspective into the distance. Wild Gunman was another launch title for the NES in 1985. It was originally created as an electromechanical game in 1974 by Gunpei Yokoi, but it was adapted to a video game format for the Famicom console in 1984. In the NES version, the player waits for the opponent's eyes to flash, accompanied by a speech bubble reading "draw" before shooting. It also features a shooting gallery where opponents are to be shot from the windows of a Wild West saloon.
Now hold on. It doesn't feel right using this for Wild Gunman. Yeah. I've got an idea.
Weeks later.
Your hands?
That's like a baby's toy.
There's something very familiar about all this. The final installment we'll be discussing on the NES is Operation Wolf. No, this isn't the only light gun game left on the system, it's just the only one I have that I haven't already discussed in a previous video. Originally released in arcades in 1987, it was ported to the NES in 1989. In the game, the player assumes the role of Special Forces soldier Roy Adams, who is attempting to rescue hostages from enemy territory. The game is in first-person perspective and is on rails, with the screen scrolling horizontally through the landscape. The player battles their way through six stages with their trusty Uzi submachine gun. Most gamers that played this game on their NES as a kid will probably tell you they opted to play it with the gamepad controller rather than the Zapper. The reason being that unlike the arcade version, the NES version only allowed you to fire one bullet at a time as opposed to the rapid fire on the arcade, so you were limited to how fast you could pull the trigger. Add that to the fact the game didn't limit the number of threats on screen despite limiting your offensive abilities, and you have a formula for a very difficult experience. It didn't take long for players to figure out that you could shoot faster using the NES controller. Also, I still meet people to this day that think you can't use grenades when you play with the Zapper. The truth is that you can, but you have to have both a controller and a Zapper plugged in when you play. Firing a grenade requires you to hold down the B button on the controller at the same time that you pull the trigger on the Zapper. All in all, Operation Wolf is a classic in the shooter genre, but I think most people that remember it fondly remember the arcade version.